The next tool in the type palette here is the type on a path tool, and this is one that you'll find that you do use quite a lot. In order for this to work, you actually need a path for the type to sit on. So in this case, I've drawn a little path here, and also I've just created a little circle there. Choose the tool, and you see that funny squiggly line at the bottom of the cursor now. Just place that anywhere at the beginning of your path and type. So I just type that on there. And now you can see that the line itself is actually defaulted to no stroke and no fill, because that's usually what you want. The text itself can be moved by getting the black arrow and just going at the beginning of the line. You see that kind of little bar there? Just get a hold of that and you'll find that you can move the text anywhere along the path. To change the size of the text, it's no good pulling these little handles here, because you'll just change the size of the path that the text is on. Just simply choose the text tool and scroll over the text, and then go to the type menu and size, and choose a size here. Now at the moment I've made that a bit big and it's sort of going off the end, so I'll just go back and make it 36, and now I can get the black arrow and I can position this anywhere on that that path there. And I can do the same with the circle tool as well. If I just choose this third one again, type on a path tool, click anywhere on the circle and then type. And there you get, you can carry on typing along there if you wish. It'll just keep going to the end. So that's how you use the type on a path tool. Can you see how I can get this here and move it anywhere I want along there? And if I get this other little sort of line here, can you see that little blue handle? If I sort of pull it inwards, I can make it go on the inside of the circle. Actually, not all versions of Illustrator have this second one, but you'll find that if you go to the first one, the one that you can move the text around with like that, just try dragging it different ways, and you'll see what you can do with that.